welcome to Your Voice with State Senator John Bonacic. I'm Mark Hansen. Senator, I understand yesterday was a big day. You and your Senate colleagues met with Governor Cuomo at the governor's mansion for lunch, and more importantly, to discuss his 2017-18 proposed budget for the next fiscal year. So I wanted to get a sense from you of the priority issues in the budget and your feelings about them.
Well, there's, in my mind, there's good and bad, because what he did was he gave basically a PowerPoint presentation of what he wanted to do, and we were seeing it for the first time. And at 7:30 last night, the actual budget details were given out to the public and the legislature in draft form. So I don't know all the details of all the things that are in there, but let me just react to some of the things that I heard. And the governor was talking, you know, of all the accolades and what we've accomplished. And we have done good things in the state of New York. There's no question about it. But I kept reminding the governor that the benchmark that we should be judging ourselves is not all of these big capital projects and all of these new press releases on free education, et cetera, but two people are leaving the state of New York for every one that comes in. It's an issue of affordability for middle-class families. And we always have to keep our eye on the ball on a population leaving the state of New York and the reasons why, and try to reverse the high tax structure in all aspects of living in the state of New York. We have a lot of good benefits, a lot of good opportunities, but our tax structure is just too high. And last year, working with the governor, we and the Republican Conference have going to drive down the state income tax over a period of time. Every year it's going to get lower. And that is, I think, a very good thing. But some of the things he talked about the child tax credit. And I'm a firm believer in that. We have so many working moms that have children that have to put their children in daycare while they go do their job. And the cost of daycare is very, very expensive. So giving tax credits, which really is a subsidy from the state of New York to help pay for daycare, that's going to increase. And it's going to make it more available to moms who are in the workforce. That was an excellent thing. He wants to spend about $115 million to transform the gridlock in Woodbury Commons, which is in Senator Larkin's district. But we all live with that gridlock, and Woodbury Commons is a very popular shopping area in Orange County down in Woodbury. And they're getting close to, I don't know, several millions of people visit there. And some days you can't move on, you know, the highlight shopping days, whether it's Easter, Thanksgiving, Christmas time. So they have to rearrange, and this has been talked about for years, but just never gets done. And he has committed this money starting in November. So we're all pleased for that. The other thing he announced recently, he wants to close the nuclear plants in Westchester County in 20 and 21. And these plants have been in existence, I don't know, many, many years. And they're always functioning at about 93% capacity. And he wants to close these down before he's developed a new supply of electricity to take care of all those homes in the southern Mid-Hudson area. I have concerns about that. I don't think you'd be shutting anything down till what's online of the alternate supply of electricity to all of those homes in southern Hudson Valley, especially the Westchester County area. So that's a concern, not counting the 1,000 jobs that are going to be lost working at the nuclear plant and 2,800 jobs that are affected indirectly. So it may be a good press release, but if we don't have an alternate supply of electricity And we closed those nuclear plants down in 20 and 21. I can't imagine what's going to happen to the electric rates for those homes. They talk about wind power. There are places we have tried to do wind power up on the mountains, and the environmentalists come in and say, oh no, that's vision pollution. We're not going to do that. So I have concerns about closing those nuclear plants, okay? The other thing that we talked about was he wants to spend, I don't know, several millions of dollars for Kennedy Airport. He showed us beautiful pictures of what Kennedy Airport would look like. He showed us the airport in Rochester. He showed us the airport in Plattekill. And these are all good. These are all good, except upstate, we don't need glitzy pictures. We need to rebuild our roads and bridges. So I would put those big capital projects on the side for a moment. I would look to do public-private partnerships if we want to move those along. But for the people that I represent in upstate New York, they want to make sure that their roads are okay and their bridges are not going to fail. And believe me, we need a lot of money in that infrastructure. I loved the water infrastructure. That was terrific. And we support that because we saw in Hoosick Falls the lead in the water pipes. We saw in Newburgh questions of lead contamination for people drinking water. And let's face it, most of, whether it's in the schools or in other water treatment facilities and pipes that have been around a long time, it's likely you're going to see more and more lead contamination in different spots throughout the state of New York. And I look at this as a beginning crisis. And we better be investing money in putting in new water infrastructure and making sure, especially the kids in school, the water is tested to make sure there are no lead contaminants. So these are some of the things that I'm reacting to that I liked in the governor's budget. Oh, and of course, with Bernie Sanders, he's out there. Free education for people whose families make less than $125,000 a year in the SUNY schools. Well, what about the people that make $126,000 a year? What about all of those middle-class families that are sacrificing to send their schools' kids to private colleges or the independent colleges? Is that fair to them? So I have deep reservations about free SUNY education money in our SUNY and CUNY system. What it will be a magnet attracting students from other states to come here. If they did get an education, do they stay here and work? Should there be work requirements? If our high schools are not getting it done in properly preparing our kids for college in English and math and sciences, and they go to these free colleges, is that now going to become a remedial college to replace what they didn't do in right in high school? And how will it affect the enrollment of all the other schools? It's not a well-thought-out plan. What it is a press release. It's a political soundbite to prepare for national, position himself, Governor Cuomo, for national office at the coattails of Bernie Sanders. That's what I view it as. I want to do more to help middle-class families, and we will. The Senate Republican Conference will, but I don't think this is the way to go.
We got 2.5 months to the state budget deadline to solve all these issues. I have every confidence in you. One of the issues that came up in the budget was the future of racing in New York State. As chair of the Senate's Committee on Racing and Wagering, you held a very important public hearing yesterday on the future of racing in New York State. Let's take a look at a clip from that.
We will do everything in our power to prevent the governor from taking money away from the racing industry And I promise you that we will work to correct this injustice and punitive arrangement that has happened with the VLTs in Nassau County. We're aware of the reduction of Naira. We're aware of the Finger Lakes problem when Tyree Casino comes on board. And we promise you we will all work to address any of those inequities. The last thing I want to say is I don't want the governor to interpret this legislative hearing as a fight with him, because I don't want polarization with the governor when it comes to protecting the racing industry, because it's important to the governor, it's important to us, and it's important to everyone that benefits from the racing industry to work together.
The good news is while that legislative hearing was going on, the governor put out a press release saying that Naira would be privatized and that he would not control the board by a majority of appointments. He will not try to reduce their cap of about $13 million, which he tried to do last year, that they will be fully funded. And so that's a good thing. The governor is cooperating in a partnership. I don't think the people realize that's not familiar with racing, what racing brings to the state of New York. There's 33,000 jobs that are associating with the racing industry, with the breeders and the horsemen. And it contributes $4.2 billion to our economy. And it's extremely important upstate, but throughout the state. So as a result of that hearing, the paramount issue that came forward was last year, there was a deal at midnight, of which most of the legislature was not privy to, of giving 1,000 VLTs to Nassau County, and they in turn made a contract with Aqueduct Resorts World, where they would give the 1,000 VLTs to Resorts World, and in return, OTB in Nassau would continue to get money from Resorts World to keep them going. And what Resorts World has done so far of the 1,000 machines has taken roughly 460 of the most profitable ones and giving those money to Nassau. They've kept a larger profit, and less money has been going to Naira and the racing industry for purses. And if the full 1,000 get implemented that way, it'll be a $20 million hit on the racing industry. So that's something that was never anticipated when that deal was made in the nighttime. So that's something that's extremely important that we have to resolve.
Well, Senator, I look forward to talking to you on future shows, not only about the future of racing, but also about more information on the state budget as your hearings and negotiations continue. Thank you very much for this information.
Well, thanks for having me. And one last thought, a healthy new year to all of our constituents. Thank you, Mark.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us.